Hello friends, let me introduce you about television production. Now, this book or this video will help you to deal with many of the techniques of television production, and it doesn't pretend to tell you how to do anything. After all, rules are meant to be broken or ignored. Still, picking the mind of a professional television producer will help you get better results every time you pick up a camera. So let me tell you something about the camera. Camera, the way you use your camera, intercut, successive shots, arrange lighting and sound will give the subject itself a certain authenticity. Now, poor or inappropriate presentation can trivialize it. On the other hand, we must never forget such down-to-earth matters as cost, time, space, facilities, personal required, etc. It is not surprising that decisions are often a choice between conflicting issues. So what is television production? Television production is often a carefully balanced compromise between artistic aspiration. What is artistic aspiration? It is desire to achieve something, to become something, like professionals, like any professional, you can say teacher, politician, acting, actor, actress, model, or farmer, anything, and hard practicality. On the other hand, there are the less tangible artistic aspects of the program. The way you present ideas will influence how your audience receives and interprets them. Like YouTube, you are making YouTube videos. Then the way you use your cameras for YouTube, making videos for YouTube, intercut successive shots, arranging lighting and sound will give the subject itself a certain authenticity. And you can present ideas or influence how your audience receives and interpret them. In this way, you can receive audiences, or you can influence the audiences from your camera, making your images, videos and all. This is all about the television production. Now, television production are usually broadcast, that is shown to a large public audience by over air or cable transmission through live during performance, or taped, that is carefully edited video recordings. This is called taped. In practice, though, you will find broadcast material packaged for home or closed circuit viewing, and see video productions aired in broadcast programs, example music videos and pop-up promos. Now, television transmissions are obliged to conform to closely controlled technical standards. Equipment is in constant use for many hours daily, so needs to be stable, robust, reliable and capable of continuous high-grade output. Now, video productions are made with equipment ranging from the most sophisticated professionals, broadcast standards, to low-cost consumer items. There is no intrinsic reason why the screened end product should differ in quality, style or effectiveness as far as the audience is concerned. Video programs today range from ambitious presentations intended for mass distribution to economically budgeted programs designed for particular audience segments. And this book or video of mine will help you whatever the scale of your production. Now, there are essentially two ways of doing television programs that are shot, either in a specially designed television studio using several cameras which are fed into a control room and assembled in a real time, or they are shot during a single camera on location and assembled later in an editing room. So there are two rooms, control room and editing room. In control room, several cameras, their television programs are shot either in a specially designed television studio using several cameras which are fed into a control room. In control room, you get several cameras. And in editing room, they are shot using a single camera. In editing room, you get a single camera on location and assembled later. Obviously, almost all non-professional video is shot using a single camera. That makes it what the pros call electronic field production, or EFP, electronic field production. The television and wider media industries are in a constant state of change with an ever-increasing number of new digital channels. So we can see all the new channels over on the television. Many new forms and styles of programming also, and the increasing convergence of television and web technologies and the development of the internet as a huge and significant arena of global communication. Now, these industries offer an extremely varied set of employment possibilities. In electronic field production, the director is like a composer of music, creating and assembling images and impressions, fitting them together carefully, weighing the quality and importance of each as he goes. So this is the work of the director in the field production. He works much as a film director would, in a linear fashion, from one shot to the next, one scene to the next. He is dealing with only one picture and one situation at a time, since the tape will be edited later. He can shoot out of sequence, repeat shots, and record extra shots to be included later. Electronic field production allows for a richness of a scene and artistic creativity, born sometimes out of necessity and sometimes out of opportunities suggested by the location itself. Now, professionals spend most of their time in planning, scripting, and organizing their production. This is the work of the professionals in their production fields. The amount of time spent actually recording the program is surprisingly short compared to the time spent preparing for it. Each program goes through several important stages, from development of the concept through planning and scripting, then on to set design or location scouting, acquisition of performers, and rehearsal. Along the way, the producer schedules his equipment, finds a competent crew, and brings all of the necessary elements together for actual production of the program. Television is an amalgam of many diverse disciplines. Professional production depends on the skill and cooperation of many people, as well as the ability of the producer and director to bring these people together in cooperative effort. So you are more likely to be a one-man band performing all the various functions yourself. This is the work of the producer. Now, what television can do and what it cannot. In today's media, television is the most dominant form. We all know this. It combines aspects of print and radio with the clarity of video. Instead of just reading or listening to what happened in a story, television viewers can see it as well. These themes or anything, if we view it, that is more understandable than by reading or by listening. With proper editing, television is the most compelling and attention-grabbing medium. It is designed to hold the viewer's attention for short periods of time and seems a perfect fit for today's fast-paced world. In a converged website, television can offer video clips of events that show the audience what happened in the accompanying story. The 24-hour television news cycle is also well suited for covering events at all times of the day, which is a challenge for radio and print. Finally, television, the most popular medium, has the greatest visibility and can be a powerful tool in promoting the converged website. It is the most powerful tools, media. Television is the most powerful tool in promoting the converged website. Any website you want to promote, it is the most powerful tool. Opportunities and limitations. In practice, you will find that a number of factors directly influence how you present a subject and the techniques you describe to use. where, for instance, you are shooting an event that has been arranged by others, you may be able to plan your general approach, but will often have to adopt techniques to suit conditions as you find them. Now, in these circumstances, there are seldom opportunities for retakes or repeat action, so you have to rely on subsequent editing to hide faults and omissions. In the empty studio, you seem to have free choice to arrange the entire action and production treatment to get exactly the effects you want. Now you have complete control over everything that is happening in the empty studio. I'm talking about now the empty studio. Theoretically, at least, the drawback of this blank sheet situation is that until you have planned and organized the program, you have nothing to shoot. While many program subjects can be shot at any time, others are more restrictive. For example, if you have to wait for the right season to see plants in bloom or go to a suitable location to find the snow required in the storyline, if you want to make this any news or if you want to publish it in the media, then you have to shoot anything like during rainy season. You have to shoot or you have to capture through the video camera the exact lightning and thundering that is occurring. Then we have to wait for that to capture this, so that and you have to wait. For example, here the example is given, you have to wait for the right season to see plants in. For the plants, if you want to describe about the plants like blooms and flowers and birds and all, then we have to wait, we have to capture. One day you will take one image, then another after 1 week, like this. And this implies to rainy season for the rainy news also, that you will see the every once in a week this rain happens, the thunders and lightnings, all you have to capture. You have to wait for that moment. If you are lucky, then you can capture it in your camera and videos. But sometimes of actions are concentrated in a limited area, example snooker table, while other activities are spread out over a broad field, example marathon runs, sky events, etc. Some situations give plenty of opportunity to select shots at leisure. Others are one-time opportunities where you need an instinct for the right moment. So these are some of the drawbacks of this blank sheet situation is that you have to plan and organize the program for rainy news, for thundering and all. You have to wait, and you have to make proper plan and organize the program, and then you cannot shoot. You have nothing to shoot then also. Then we come to the point of the television today. For most people, television is just another of those taken for granted amenities, part of our everyday life, like radio, films and newspapers, a welcome diversion. Yet in reality, television is forming the taste, the opinions and the aspirations of the world. Now, television provides us with a regular communication channels through which we keep up with the latest news, discover what the weather is likely to be, enjoy game shows, movies, talks and discussions, learn a little more about society and the world we live in. It is there. So we watch television, and what is the condition of television today? That it provides us how the television communicates with us, how the media communicates with us. It is a channel through which we keep up with the latest news, discover whether it is likely to be, enjoy game shows like the Olympic Games, movies, talks and discussions, learn a little more about society but it is decreasing. We are not learning anything more about the society, but yes, we are enjoying the game shows like Olympic Games. We accept it all pretty casually, but as you read through the following chapters examining the equipment, the techniques and the process of television program making, you will begin to see how this window on the world in the corner of the living room is far from the natural extended eye it appears to be. What seems to the viewer to be a straightforward enough process is really the result of carefully selected techniques. We shall be exploring these techniques and see how they influence our audience interpretation and response to what they are seeing. There is nothing threatening about this. It is persuasive craftsmanship akin to that used in marketing, advertising and similar presentation fields. Now it is very common in television, we always see this advertising, match, that is sports, news. These are some of the things we see in the media or in movies, but we are not getting any. Society also we get, like if you go to the channel of the Kisan channel, then there you will learn a little more about society. The medium is inherently persuasive. Even if we use it casually, it will still continue to influence. But if we use techniques carelessly or messily, the programs will have no coherent form. So we have to use these techniques very carefully. They will simply be boring to watch. If you use these techniques carelessly, then it will be very boring to watch. If you are watching the movies, or if you are watching the news, or if you are watching the games or sports, if someone distracts you, if someone tells you, okay, you do this work at that moment, then your mind distracts, no? Then you get less interest to watch the TVs, and then it simply, the program becomes boring. This is the programs of this. The social impact of television. What is the social impact? Now we come to this point. Television is a window on the world for news and information, all we know. Newspapers and the print media provide a degree of separation from reality, but TV graphically brings happenings right into living rooms, complete with color, sound, time sequences, and even to some degrees the associated films. This is the work of the TV. Newspapers and print media provides us a degree of separation from reality, but TV brings happenings right into living rooms. We can see the life. Reading about thousands of children starving in Africa or some other country is one thing. Actually, seeing the misery is quite another. Reading about people being tortured because of their political beliefs is one thing. Hearing the people involved talk about what happened to them and seeing their scars and maybe even their tears is quite another. Compared to newspapers, television may be superficial when it comes to reporting facts. However, good pictures can still be worth 1,000 words. Pictures can convey many things beyond facts and statistics. In democracies, television can be used to inform the electorate about things they need to know to make informed choices at the ballot box. When TV is responsibly programmed and viewed with a critical, educated eye, it's capable of looking through the gloss and facades of people and events, giving us glimpses of the reality lying beneath about the ballot. It is capable of looking. When TV is responsibly programmed and viewed with a critical, educated eyes to inform the electorate about things they need to know to make informed choices at the ballot box, it is capable of looking through the gloss and packets of people and events, giving us glimpses of the reality lying beneath. Television is capable of making us an eyewitness to events as they happen. These events can range from the hostile invasion of a country to Monday night football in this regard. TV breaks down the barriers of distances and becomes an extension of our senses. Now, television provides needed escape and relaxation. Why it is needed? We relax by watching TV. Suffice it to say, television allow us to momentarily escape our problems and experience the experiences of other people. We can become awestruck with beauty of and grace of the arts, or caught up in the frenzy and excitement of an athletic event. We can even allow ourselves to be momentarily lost in a beautiful fantasy world. Thus, our spirits can be lifted and sometimes even hope and faith restored. Now, television introduces new ideas and information. Before the mass media, an important threat to health, a new medicine or improved ways of doing things could take months or even years to become commonly known, like coronavirus. So the coronavirus, what happens? A new medicine, improved ways of doing things takes months or even years to become commonly known. The medicines of the coronavirus. Today, that time is typically cut down to a day or even a few hours. Included in this category are new products and services that will make our life easier or safer. New recipes, important safety procedures, and even instructions on home improvement and repair. With television, we are put in the center of the marketplace of ideas. We can compare these ideas, evaluate them, and then decide for ourselves whether to accept or reject them. These new ideas can also threaten traditional beliefs and the established order of doing things. But we must keep in mind that a society does not allow itself to change and adjust to the times may find that internal pressures mount to a point of an explosion in the form of political revolution or widespread internal violence. This has happened in many countries throughout history. In the minds of some analysts, the reluctance to make needed changes was what brought on the recent disintegration of Soviet Russia, the USSR, one of the largest and most powerful nations in the world. Even on a personal level, not to change can mean that we get left behind professionally and replaced by people with newer ideas, or even be replaced by a machine. In today's competitive information center world, to stand still is to fall behind. Now, TV volumes. Those who criticize television for showing gratuitous violence cite the findings noted in the last module that US children typically see 16,000 murders on TV by the time they are 18. Now, most of these murders appears to be without consequence, and most are represented as the ready solution to a problem. But in real life, violence and murder normally have profound and lingering effects on both the people involved and on their friends and families. This painful reality is normally glossed over or ignored in film and TV drama. It is significant that even 80% of Hollywood executives who have vested interest in maintaining profit-related violence in on TV feels there's a link between TV violence and the real-life violence, they believe. Study shows that heavy viewers of TV violence tend to be more paranoid about the level of violence around them. They also tend to be more suspicious of people in general and more inclined to view their surroundings as unsafe. Now, in this regard, it is time for another reality check. Although you might not be able to tell it from watching TV news or crime dramas, which tend to emphasize violence, overall, the percentage of most types of violent crime in the United States has actually been decreasing. Depiction of casual sex in the minds of many not only is casual sex a sin, but it leads to life-threatening disease and unwanted pregnancies. But a reality check is important in this respect. Even though some influential US groups have opposed sex education, the two-decade decline in the rate of unwanted pregnancies in the United States is due largely to sex education, motivated in measure by an open discussion of these issues in the media. Countries where sex education information has even been more readily available have even lower rates of unwanted pregnancies and sexually transmitted disease. So till here, we have discussed about the television news or the production of television. What is television production? And television provides needed escape and relaxation. The ideas and information, introduction of ideas and information, social impact of television, what is television today, opportunities and limitations, what television can do and what it cannot. And we have introduced to the television production. So till here we have discussed. Now we will start with the other moral issues. Thank you. Please do watch my videos and subscribe to my channel. And